Now I am going to discuss a theorem on periodic function. First, I am going to discuss about the statement of the periodic function theorem and how we can find out the proof of that periodic function which is related to the Laplace transforms. Okay, the theorem statement is, let f of t be a periodic function at particular t, in that the Laplace transforms f of t is equal to integral 0 to capital T e power minus s small t f of t dt by 1 minus e power minus st. Okay, the theorem statement of periodic function is, if f of t is a periodic function with period capital T, then Laplace transform of periodic function f of t is equal to integral 0 to t e power minus st f of t dt by 1 minus e power minus s capital T. It is the proof. That is nothing but Laplace transform of the periodic function is equal to 1 by 1 minus e power minus st integral 0 to t e power minus st f of t dt. Okay. Here, the proof of the periodic function of the Laplace transform. In general, by the definition of the Laplace transform, L of f of t is equal to integral 0 to infinity e power minus st f of t dt. Let it be equation 1. Okay. This 0 to infinity can be divided into partitions, that is 0 to t e power minus st f of t dt plus integral t to 2t. Why? Because t is a period. Okay. Before of this, given that f of t is a periodic function with period t, that is nothing but 0 to t, 0 to infinity can be divided into 0 to t, t to 2t, 2t to 3t, so on up to infinity. Okay, that is nothing but by the definition of the periodic function, f of t equal to f of small t plus capital T, it is equal to f of small t plus 2t, it is equal to so on. From this, the Laplace transform L of f of t is equal to integral 0 to infinity e power minus st f of t dt, that is equal to integral 0 to t e power minus st f of t dt plus integral t to 2t e power minus st f of t dt plus integral 2t2 3t e power minus st f of t dt plus so on. Okay, in this case we are taking put small t is equal to u plus t in the first, u plus t in second integral, t equal to u plus 2t in the third integral, so on. If we are taking the limits of second integral, limits of second integral, lower limit is, if we take lower limit is capital T, then T minus T it is equal to 0, that is U equal to 0. The capital 2T, the upper limit is capital 2T, 2T minus T small t, that is equal to U equal to 0 to T. These values substitute in the above expression, L of F of T is equal to integral 0 to t e power minus st f of t dt plus integral 0 to t integral t to 2 t e power minus s u plus t into f of u plus t dt and plus integral 2t to 3t e power minus s u plus 2t into f of u plus 2t dt plus so on. Here L of f of t is equal to, in the first case, 0 to t e power minus st f of t dt. In the second integral, minus su is right outside. In this case, here minus st taking right outside, minus st integral t to 2t e power minus su f of u plus capital T dt plus in the second, in the third integral e power minus 2st taking outside 2t to 3t e power minus su f of u plus 2t dt plus so on. Here L of f of t is equal to, applying the limits, that is applying the upper limit and lower limit for the second integral, in the same way in the third integral we are getting u equal to 0 and u equal to t, then the variable is changes into u into small t, then that becomes integral 0 to t e power minus st f of t dt plus integral 0 to t, in the second term e power minus st integral 0 to t e power minus st f of t dt, the third integral e power minus 2st integral 0 to t e power minus st f of t dt plus so on. Here in the case of upper limit and lower limit, u equal to 0, u equal to t, in the second integral, in the third integral also, we are getting the same limits u equal to 0 and u equal to t. For the change of variable u equal to small t, no change in the variable u and t. So, here I can write in the place of u, t directly. Okay. This is the variable changes and limits changes. In all cases, the function value is t only. The function value is t only and the coefficients are right outside. Those are the constants. In all terms, taking common integral 0 to t e power minus st f of t dt. This integral value is common for all the terms. So, the remaining terms are, in the first part, only one is a constant. In the second one, plus e power minus st. In the third term, e power minus 2 st plus so on. It is the infinite integral. We can take up to infinity. We know that by the exponential, this is 1 minus e power minus st whole inverse into integral 0 to t e power minus st f of t dt. This is equal to L of f of t is equal to, it is taking to the denominator 1 by 1 minus e power minus st into integral 0 to t e power minus st f of t dt. Here capital T is a period and small t is a variable. Okay? By using this relation, we can find out the given functions, periodic functions, Laplace transforms. Here, when f of t is a periodic function with period t, then the Laplace transform of periodic function f of t is equal to 1 by 1 minus e power minus st integral 0 to t e power minus st f of t dt. Only in this case, if the function is periodic function, we can take the limits 0 to which is the period, we write the upper limit and that period is right in 1 by 1 minus e power minus st. Okay, it is very important. You remember that statement of the theorem of periodic function with period t. By using of this theorem statement, we can solve the given problems of periodic functions. Okay, thank you.